Hello, YouTube. Residents of the South Ural village of Metlino, located near the borders of the East Ural Nature Reserve and the unfinished South Ural nuclear power plant, they have been suffering for several years due to an unusual scourge, the invasion of Kivsyaks or Julida, which is an order of millipedes. While black millipedes encased in a chitinous shell have invaded the surrounding forests, and more recently they have increasingly encroached on the homesteads of local residents. Where did such exotic creatures come from to the southern Urals? And should the locals expect further expansion of the strange millipedes in the rest of the Chelyabinsk region? And what measures are scientists taking to stop the population growth of these unusual creatures? The harsh Ural Julida are not afraid of frosts. It's worth starting with the fact that the black millipedes are actually not so black, but dark gray, and they're called scientifically Kivsyak gray. In Latin, Rosiulus Kessler. These generally harmless creatures live in forests, feed on fallen leaves and withered grass. In its natural habitat, the Julida has almost no enemies. Nature has endowed these unusual creatures with powerful means of protection, a durable chitinous shell and glands capable of secreting prussic acid, an odorous liquid. The great Kivsyak, we're going to call it either Julida or Kivsyak, so get used to two names. Well, they really grow. It really grows more than 5 centimeters in length, so there is no need to confuse the small Ural centipede with their tropical relatives. I wonder if you have seen those. Well, the great Julida is highly fertile. Up to 5 million individuals can live on 1 hectare. This species is ubiquitous in the forests of central Russia. It is believed that millipedes like a temperate climate and high humidity. However, as practice shows, they can take root in most severe conditions, especially if they are caused to by exterior stimuli. So what we're dealing here is an experiment that got out of control. One of the main issues remains the history of the appearance of the Kivsyaks in the perimeter of an abandoned nuclear power plant and their further spread throughout the surrounding areas. According to one account, the millipedes were brought to the East Ural Reserve several years ago as part of an experiment in biological reclamation of soils contaminated with radioactive elements after the accident at the Mayak site in 1957. If you had seen my video, The Alien Liked Sweets, then you know something about this accident. But let me provide more details. The Kishtym disaster, sometimes referred to as the Mayak disaster or Azorsk disaster in more recent sources, so to say, was a radioactive contamination accident that occurred on September 29, 1957 at Mayak, a plutonium production site for nuclear weapons and nuclear fuel reprocessing plant located in the off-limits or closed city of Chelyabinsk 40. Now it's Azorsk, in the Chelyabinsk region of the Russian Soviet Federal Socialist Republic of the Soviet Union. The disaster is the second worst nuclear incident by radioactivity released after the Chernobyl disaster. It is the only disaster classified as level 6 on the International Nuclear Event Scale, which ranks by population impact, making it the third worst after the two level 7 events, the Chernobyl disaster, which resulted in the evacuation of 335,000 people, and the Fukushima Daiichi disaster, which resulted in the evacuation of 154,000 people. Well, In 1957, at least 22 villages were exposed to radiation from the Kishtim disaster, with a population of around 10,000 people evacuated. Some were evacuated after a week, but it took almost 2 years for evacuations to occur at other sites there. According to the scientists, the Kivsaks were supposed to eat a layer of forest litter infected with radioactive nuclides, accumulating all radioactive elements and releasing a clean product into the environment in the form of fertilizers. Despite its more than modest size, the Julida is a very voracious creature. While the basis of their diet is plant food, namely fallen leaves, mushrooms, and rotten plant shoots, the Julida eats everything that other species do not covet, while the resulting humus itself is a fertilizer. In classical soil science, humus is the dark organic matter in soil that is formed by the decomposition of plant and animal matter. It is a kind of soil organic matter. It is rich in nutrients and retains moisture in the soil. Humus is the Latin word for earth or ground. It is possible that at some stage of the experiment, and perhaps even after its completion, a very large population of millipedes remained in the natural landfill. Thus, the uncontrolled increase in the population has led to the expansion of the boundaries of their habitat. Judging by the materials from local media, for the first time, the issue of controlling the population of the Julida was raised in 2015, when the residents of Metlino increasingly began to notice uninvited guests on their plots. However, after the Kivsak invasion became known to the local masses, so to say, information appeared that the fight against millipedes has been going on for many years, since the early 1990s. The Kivsaks have been besieging the abandoned South Ural nuclear power station, located a couple dozen kilometers from Metlino. The territory of the so-called regime facility is under protection, meaning off-limits, so the public did not know about the dominance of the abandoned station by the Kivsaks. Who knows what else is going on there, or what they have turned into. Apparently, over the past few years, the population of this species has increased many times, and their habitat has spread to the outskirts of a residential village. There was an old science fiction story by Arthur Conan Doyle about mutated ants in Brazil. I encourage you to read it. It's very interesting. But let's get back to the Julida. To date, it can be confidently noted that despite the fact that the habitat conditions are highly ideal, millipedes have managed to adapt to the harsh Ural climate, and without encountering natural enemies on their way, fill up the formed ecological niche. By the way, according to the Russians, some enterprising Western businessmen specially breed Julida and sell their vital products, so to say, as fertilizers. The demand for such a product among gardeners is huge. But I don't think they're mutated, that kind of Julida. Not the most pleasant appearance of these creatures has led to rumors that the Kivsaks are almost deadly, and any contact with these creatures can end in tragedy. According to some Ural researchers, there is no reason for such fears. Julida itself is absolutely harmless to humans. However, people suffering from allergies need to be extremely careful, since prussic acid released by the millipede can cause an allergic reaction. However, the problem of the Kivsak seriously worry the South Urals population, since the neighborhood with a massive number of fed millipedes is not the best scenario. In 1922, Ural area researchers had the opportunity to personally visit the Metlino area in the zone of such strange interspecific biological confrontation. And they noted that the number of the Julida really stunned them. They were everywhere, and this is despite the fact that the researchers I'm speaking about, and I usually go through their materials, they present very interesting ones about the Urals. But anyway, these researchers did not enter the forest and explore the depth of the reserves because the unauthorized visits are strictly prohibited. So they didn't really see what's going on in that reserve and in the thick forests. This is how the surroundings of Metlina look like in 2022. Today, the situation could be very different. However, it should be noted that there were many more dead millipedes along the road than the alive ones in 2022, apparently fallen under the influence of some chemical reagent used as means of countering the size of the julipet population, of the Julida population. It remains to be hoped that the use of chemicals will not have a detrimental effect on the environment by disrupting the flimsy biological balance and will not cause more harm to nature and man as a result of this operation than the foul-smelling millipedes. So basically, speaking straightforward, we have here mutated millipedes that were initially, they were brought to the area to mitigate the consequences of a nuclear accident that took place over 7 decades ago. And they are expanding. And apparently, we already know from local rumors, which are being quashed, of course, that the encounters can be deadly. But you see, the humans have harmed Ural Mountains nature in other ways too, and even earlier. So let me tell you one example. During the Soviet era, in the Orenburg region, at the Totsky training ground, on September 14, 1954, large-scale military tactical exercises were held with the involvement of 45,000 military personnel. They were held under the command of Marshal Zhukov himself, and the highlight of the program of these exercises was the explosion of an atomic bomb. Officially, the event was called a breakthrough of the prepared tactical defense of the enemy using nuclear weapons, namely the RDS-2 atomic bomb, which had a capacity of about 40 kilotons, if that's what was used. That was twice the power of the bombs dropped by the Americans on Hiroshima and Nagasaki. The same RDS-2 had already been tried before. It was blown up at the landfill near Semipalatinsk in Kazakhstan in 1951. In addition to 45,000 Soviet military personnel, about 600 tanks and self-propelled guns, and as many armored personnel carriers, about 500 artillery pieces and mortars, 300 aircraft, 6,000 tractors and vehicles were involved in the exercises. They dropped the atomic bomb from an airplane at the conditional well-fortified defensive support node of the conditional enemy, dubbed Western, which had to be broken through to disrupt the stability of the entire defense of this Western, followed by undermining the combat capability of the entire main group. Where the explosion occurred, the sand became granule glass. From the 2-4 strategic bomber, from the altitude of 8,000 meters, the RDS-2 bomb was dropped at 9 hours, 34 minutes in the morning. The atomic explosion was heard at an altitude of 350 meters from the surface of the earth. In addition, 2 stacks of boxes with TNT and barrels of gasoline were blown up as simulators of the second and third nuclear explosions. Signed documents for non-disclosure of military secrets for the period of 25 years were taken from all the participants in the exercises. And it was only after the collapse of the USSR that the memories of direct participants in the tests and eyewitnesses, residents of the surrounding villages, began to appear in the media. Those who were still alive and relatively healthy, because many had already died of cancer, provoked by radiation exposure by that time, the soldiers' protection was limited during those tests to ordinary gas masks, rubber gloves, and stockings. Listen to this. I'm going to read you from somebody's personal statement. I was lying in a deep trench, 6 kilometers away from the explosion. First there was a bright flash, then everyone heard such a loud explosion that they went deaf for a minute or two, and immediately they felt just a wild heat which made them wet. It became difficult for everyone to breathe. The walls of our trench literally closed over us. I had to dig myself out, recalled Leonid Pogrebnoy, a participant in the Totsky exercises. I'm a veterinarian by education, so I was assigned to work with animals, horses, large and small cattle, pigs, and even rabbits. We placed them about half a kilometer from the supposed epicenter of the explosion, under different types of shelters, horses under concrete shelters, pigs under plank shelters, cows under pile shelters, rabbits and goats inside airplanes and tanks. Only the horses and a few cows were left alive, but it was pity to look at them too. It was as if they had been doused with boiling water. The animals were taken away for study. So, as you can see, not only the soil suffered from military testing in the Urals. And of course, the Soviets were not the only ones in all of this nuclear shenanigans. It was easier to keep the information undercover in the totalitarian society. But the impact mankind has caused to the planet with its continuous military technology development experiments is terrifying. I'm not even including AI here. I think this is the reasons UFOs have been sighted quite frequently in the Ural Mountains. And who knows, maybe they can save us from our dangerous experiments. I want to thank you for your attention to my work. And if you can support my research, you can do so in the through the links you'll find in the description to this channel. Please like my videos. Please tell others about my channel.